last period we have seen classification of Whittaker's five kingdom system of classification. We also have seen merits and demerits of Whittaker's system of classification. Now we will see last topic of the lesson number 1, living world and classification of microbe. Last topic name is classification of microbe. What is meaning of microbe? Living organisms which are very small in size, which cannot be seen by our naked eyes, they are called as a microorganisms or microbes. Whittaker classified all the microorganisms specially in 5 groups. Which are the 5 groups in which their microbes are classified? First, they are classified according to whether the nucleus is well developed or not. If nucleus is not well developed, these microbes are grouped as a prokaryotes. Pro, the meaning of pro is nucleus is not well developed. Second category is eukaryotes. Eukaryotes means nucleus is well developed. So all the microbes who are prokaryotes are grouped in bacteria. Bacteria, for example, like staphylococci, lactobacillus, they are grouped in the category prokaryotic group. So second group is eukaryotes. U means they have well developed cell organelles like nucleus, plastids, chloroplast, all the cell organelles are well developed. That are again 4 type protista. Protista means the name itself suggests protozoans. Protozoans means amoeba, paramecium, plasmodium, all these are the examples of protozoans. They are grouped in the group protista. Next category is fungi. They do not have chlorophyll, they could not produce their own food by the process of photosynthesis. They have tough cell wall which is made up of chitin. These all the microorganisms are grouped in the fungi group category. What are the special features we will see afterwards. The next category is algae. They have chlorophyll, then they can produce their own food by the process of photosynthesis. Next category is viruses, last one. Virus means what? They are the smallest in size, smallest microorganism in size. Their size is in nanometer. They are very small in size, smallest microorganism, viruses. So first we will see characteristics of bacteria. Bacteria are available in different shapes and size. For example, if they are round shape, circle shape, they are called as a cocci. For example, staphylococci. Here cocci, this word suggests that that organism shape is circular, round shape. Second example, cocobacilli means what? They are round and rod shape. They are in between, means oval shape. That name is called as a cocobacilli. Next shape is bacilli. If their shape is rod shape, they are called as a bacillus. Rod shape bacteria are called as a bacilli. For example, lactobacilli are the rod shape. Next is vibrio. If their shape is a comma like, so they are called as a vibrio. For example, vibrio cholera. The pathogen or the organism, bacteria, which causes cholera disease, its shape is a comma shape. So the name is vibrio cholera. According to its shape, it has a name. Next is, if that shape is a zigzag, spirillum, that shape size is called as a spirillum shape. So bacteria are different shapes, sizes. Sometimes they remain in a single independent, or they remain in the colonies or groups. These are the characteristics of bacteria. They are unicellular, prokaryotic, nucleus is not well developed. Second group is protista. As already I told you, all the protozoans like hydra, amoeba, paramecium are grouped in protista. They have locomotory organs like flagella, pseudopodia, cilia to capture the food or in search of food or to escape from enemy. They have locomotory organ. All these organisms are grouped in a protista. What are the characteristics of protista? That they have locomotory organ, they are eukaryotic, unicellular organism. And next group is fungi. Characteristic, all the fungi means they do not have ability to produce their food. What are characteristics? Fungi, examples are yeast, mushroom, mold, baker's yeast, that is used in bakery product. All these are grouped in a fungi category. Their cell wall is made up of chitin, complex sugar. So next characteristics of fungi, what are that? They are eukaryotic, cell wall is made up of chitin. They are heterotrophic in nature. These are the characteristics of fungi group. Next is algae. What is meaning algae? They have chlorophyll for production of their own food. Photosynthesis process they can perform. All the algae, they may be unicellular or multicellular. Example of unicellular algae is chlorella. So these algae, what are characteristics? They have chlorophyll. They can produce their own food. Eukaryotic in nature. Nucleus is well developed. They may be unicellular or multicellular. Last category is viruses. As we know that viruses are extremely small in size. They cannot be seen. All the microorganisms we cannot see by our naked eyes. But viruses are the smallest microorganism which can be seen only under electron microscope. Other these fungi, bacteria, protozoans we can see under simple compound microscope. But these viruses, they are very small in size. We need to see them electron microscope. The special features of viruses are they are smallest microorganisms and they are called as the age of living and non-living. What is meaning age? That sometime when they are outside the human beings, animals, they show like a non-living organism. They show like a non-living particle. But they when they enter in our plants, animal cell, they behave like a living. So they are called as the age of living and non-living viruses. Next, they causes diseases to plants and animals. For example, for tomato, tomato wilt virus. The leaves of tomato get wilted. So in human beings also different viral infections are there, like cold, flu. These are the viral infections. In animals also they causes different virus viral infections. So viruses are causing infection to the plants, animals, human beings, all.